Hey guys, and welcome back to Battlefront updates and some Star Wars Battlefront 2 news. Now that the weekend is here, or well, it's Friday still, but according to Battlefront 2, the weekend is here because we're not getting a double XP weekend, we are getting a vehicle weekend. This is actually the first battle point event that they have done so far, and what they've basically done is reduce the battle point price of all the vehicles during the weekend, and they reduced them quite a lot actually, because if you take a look right here, you can see that the MTT is only 75 battle points and the AAT 275. I'm gonna be honest and say that I don't remember exactly how much they were before, but I think they've reduced the battle point cost by probably 75% or similarly. And some of you might be going, oh no, that means more ATSDs, more ships, and yeah, you're right. It's probably not gonna be super balanced gameplay this weekend, but you know what? I don't mind, because this means we will have a completely different gameplay flow, and the fact that they're willing to do these kind of events that actually affects the gameplay and isn't just double XP, it's really interesting to me, because it opens up a whole new box of opportunities where they could do similar events where maybe they reduce the cost of a specific hero, or they increase the amount of heroes available in Galactic Assault. And all of these things are fine if you just do them during a limited set of days to make sure that you don't permanently unbalance the game. So I think that's very interesting, and I would love to hear if you guys have any suggestions on what kind of other weekends they could do. And you can probably head out to Ben's Twitter account and respond to his announcement tweet if you have any good suggestions. But yeah, I can imagine there will be a little bit of frustration at least when there's gonna be a lot of ATSTs on maps like Crate, but since it is a limited time event, I can definitely live with that for the sake of getting some new gameplay variety. But if we move on, it seems like videos slash stream content is progressing for Battlefront 2, because when Ben and Dennis tweeted about this new thing DICE are doing with their Twitter account, where a developer takes over the account and answers questions, someone asked, can you do the same for Battlefront 2? And Ben responded saying, we will, it's already in operation. We had to delay our filming of the first video, or it would have been out by now. So, it sounds like videos might be the first thing we will get before potential streams. And it does seem like they're already progressing with that, and will be filming, if they haven't already filmed it, their first video very soon. And I think that makes sense in terms of getting through approvals and all that kind of stuff. It's probably a lot easier with a video you can't control compared to a live stream, but I still have my fingers crossed that the actual live streams will be happening eventually, hopefully around each reveal, and well, I would like to see one every week, even if there's no news, where they would simply talk with the developers, maybe play the game and go over potential community transmissions and so on. And if we move on, Ben was asked in the same conversation on Reddit if we will be seeing some Grievous or Obi-Wan footage, and he said at some point yes. So, not really anything newsworthy, to be honest, but I wanted to bring it up nevertheless, because I think that means that hopefully there will be some type of game changer events or just official gameplay that they will record and put out of Grievous and Obi-Wan before they are out, because it's always a great way to kind of hype up the characters instead of people logging on for the first time on release day and not having seen any gameplay whatsoever. And you guys might remember that they promised to add the N1 Starfighter to the Hero Starfighters game mode and some other places, since it's currently only available on Galactic Assault on Naboo, and he did say that it will be added to Hero Starfighters and Arcade in a future update. And the reason to why it didn't happen, it's actually pretty simple. The UI didn't fit the ship, and that's why they couldn't add the N1 Starfighter. So once the UI team fixes that and makes sure that there's room for the N1 Starfighter, it will be added to Hero Starfighters and Arcade. But those are all the direct Battlefront 2 news, but there is something I wanted to bring up here that I do think is important for the entire Battlefront community, and honestly all EA games, because Ben brought up on Twitter yesterday responding to someone complaining that there is a bit too much clickbait in the Battlefront community, with, is why I'm implementing a zero clickbait policy. Produce clickbait content, you don't work with me, I hate it. It is the modern day equivalent of browser pop-ups. And he later clarified that this is indeed new rules coming to all game changers that they will be enforcing at some point soon. And I think this is really good to hear, and I want to make something very clear. I'm not talking about specific people here, I'm talking about clickbait overall. It's no good for the community, because people constantly get misled, and I have to answer people going, oh, I heard this is coming to the game, by saying, No, it's not. That was made up news, or that was just misleading information overall. So the fact that they're actually enforcing this as a game changer rule is really good. Obviously, not all people are game changers, so it's not gonna have a whole lot of impact for that. But anyone who's currently working with EA as a game changer, or who wants to become a game changer, needs to follow these rules. And I think that's really good, because it's not illegal to clickbait. It's understandable that people do it out of a business perspective if they want to get more views, and so far there hasn't been any repercussions whatsoever if you do that, except for the occasional community backlash. But right now, if anyone who wants to at any point work with EA decide that they would rather clickbait or mislead the community, that means that they lose the opportunity to go to capture events and so on. So for that, I'm very happy about Ben saying this, and the response was very positive from like 99% of the people, including other game changers. So I definitely think this is a step in the right direction. But that brings this video to an end. Thank you very much for watching, and as always, may the Force be with you.